you're sitting around and you have nowhere to go. No, you don't. Come on in. Welcome to the Cranky Show.
Dr. Cranky in the Lab-RAT-ory, back with another Cranky Show. And more coffee, always let there be more coffee. I'm sure by now all of you are waking up and finding CT SpeedShop's new video where he's introducing, a new character, of course. More importantly, he brings up the whole question of what do we use, RATTLECAN, AIRBRUSH. And although it took him just a few, less than a minute to ask that question, it's an important question and one that we've been dealing with ever since we started building models here in the laboratory. And I have to say that that for me here in the laboratory, that question does not have an answer, or at least not an easy answer. So I'm going to go over what we do and why we do it the way we do it, and then you can go back through the archives and see, what's there in terms of painting and all of that. And this is not going to be in any way, shape, or form a painting video. I'm just going to be talking about RATTLECAN and also airbrushing. Now, depending on where you are on your development as a model builder, most of us, like you, we started rattle canning, meaning, the reason why they call it rattle is because it's got a ball bearing in there to stir up the paint. This is a can of my favorite primer, Plasticoat. And which also, by the way, makes a paint line of enamel, and we'll talk about this later on, because one of the things that we do here in the laboratory is, for example, we still rattle can all the time. We love to rattle can our primer, and we also love to rattle can our metallizers. Rattle canning always will go faster as a process than airbrushing. And so that's a very quick and important distinction. You break out the can, you warm it up a little bit, and you're good to go. You shake it for a couple of minutes, and you're good to go. And it's always easy. You put the cap back on, put it on the shelf. It's always there. It's always ready to go. Whereas with the airbrush, and I just have my handy dandy, lovely Iwata Neo right here that we've been getting a lot of use from, even though we have, we have most of the airbrushes by Iwata, and we love them all, but they, and they have their different uses. But the Neo is a all-around good entry-level airbrush, which very quickly will show you the difference, you have to keep it clean, you have to maintain it, you have to strip it down, put it back together. It's a big deal. And so what we do is we always get together anywhere between a half a dozen to a dozen bodies, and we paint. We have a couple of days, say a weekend, a painting fest. This is true for those of you who are in above the Mason-Dixon, where it gets really cold, 15 months out of the year. And you want to stock up so that you could then airbrush indoors during that time, or prep everything and get it ready for assembly during the coldest, unfriendliest winter months when you are indoors. There's very little to do, and yet you want to build models. So that's what we do, and that's what we recommend. We store up. The other thing why we do that is that, again, it requires, let's say you're using two or three airbrushes or one airbrush. I have several because that way I can move around and not spend most of my time cleaning the suckers, because there's always some factor that's going to make you stop and look over it. And the Pache H set is also a wonderful airbrush, And that one, you could have a whole bunch of bottles with different colors, and or if you're spraying clear. So my advice is to get your hands on, you know, write the companies or go on their website, the companies that you're interested in, like, for example, Auto Air. Every company has a brochure, you know, Iwata, and more importantly, House of Color. This is their, you know, tech catalog, tech manual. From way back in 2005. I mean, the information is still valid. So, you know, you do a little bit of research, you learn about paint systems and you know, what each paint line will do for you, and then you go from there. So you inform yourself, you do that kind of information seeking first hand, and before you commit paint to plastic. We do a variety of painting things here. We rattle can our primers. We often will do a metallizer on the engine parts, which is also rattle canned. And then we come in and we normally, because we worry about the finish, we use the airbrush, because the airbrush will often lay down a very thin coat of paint, and you can regulate